Hello everyone, this is Judiah, and I wanted to make a video about why I'm no longer a Christian. I've seen some Hebrew Israelites make videos about their decision towards converting from Christianity, and I wanted to make a video as well about my experience as a Christian and the reason why I've decided to no longer be one. The Most High has planted a seed in me, and month after month and year after year, he's watered it and I've grown. I'm no longer afraid to speak out against Christianity. I'm just grateful to no longer be in that trap. I'm no longer caught up in that web, but I used to be. For a long time I was, and so caught up that I was afraid to ask all the right questions. They have you paying them, sowing seed into fertile ground in order to receive whatever blessing you're expecting from the Most High. But see, nowhere in the Bible does it say you have to pay to receive from him. In fact, it was Peter who said to the sorcerer in Acts chapter 8:20, "May your money perish with you because you thought you could buy gifts of God with money." He told him he was wicked for thinking he could purchase anything from the Most High. And the Messiah said upon Peter he would build his church. So I don't know where the prosperity gospel comes from. It doesn't come from the word. It certainly doesn't come from Peter. And it doesn't come from the Messiah. So they're teaching you that obedience means coming to church every Sunday, supporting your church financially, working for your church and helping your pastor pursue his dreams in ministry, paying your tithes and offerings. And then they feed you a few Pauline scriptures, you know, taken out of context, to make you feel good. And you jump up and down and you shout hallelujah like a robot. But the preacher says jump and you say how high. You know, but I wish your preacher would read to you Romans 10, chapter 10, verse 1. And it says, "My people are zealous, but their zeal is not based on knowledge." Or Amos 5:23, and it says, "Take away from me your noise of your songs, for I will not hear the melody of your harps." See, we think because we make a joyful noise in praise and worship, and we put on a good show to lure more members in, that we're doing the Most High a favor, but he's not interested in entertainment, you know, in the place of true worship. He says in John 4:24, "Those who worship him must do so in spirit and truth, and the truth is far from us. So how can we call what we do true worship?" Even in Paul's day, they made a bunch of noise in church, excited for the Most High, but excited about the wrong things. You don't have the right to shout hallelujah when you don't walk in the truth and you seek after things he did not ordain. You don't have the right to shout hallelujah for that. Now, the preacher tells you God's getting ready to turn it all around and God's getting ready to pour out his blessings on you. God's always getting ready to do something. And like a programmed robot, we jump up and down and shout. And then we've been programmed to think that if we sow money into these words, we will receive those blessings. Zealous, see, but dumb. This is the prosperity gospel at work, and it's working well for these pastors. When you see these mega churches in LA and Atlanta and Dallas and all around now, they're full of naive Christians. These ministers don't care anything about your faithful attendance in church. All they want is your money so badly now that some churches have put ATM machines in their foyer. ATM machines, because they want to make sure that you have access to your money. But listen, I'm not an atheist. I'm not the Antichrist. I'm not an anti-Semitic. I'm none of these things. I'm a woman of the Most High. I follow after the truth. I no longer follow the masses. I'm not a robot any longer. And when I see something doesn't add up, I question it. And that was the key thing to becoming who I am today, questioning the mess that was going on in the Christian church. I was a Christian for about 18 years, and I got saved at 13. And about 2 years ago, about age 31, I announced that I am no longer a Christian. I had just gotten a master's degree in theology, and thankfully I didn't go to one of those schools that fed me a lie. You know, the school that I went to did not paint a perfect picture of Christianity. It exposed its good and its corruption. And it was in seminary school that I learned the truth about Christianity. So really, I went from calling myself a Christian to calling myself a theologian because I was no longer afraid to ask the right questions. Then I embraced my true identity. I'm a Hebrew Israelite. I'm no longer a religion. I'm my nationality, my true nationality, not some race given to me by European slave masters. I'm not African American. Just because you purchased my people from Africa and brought us to America doesn't make us what you say we are. And we're so naive. You know, we followed in the footsteps of those who had our ancestors enslaved. See, we're perfectly physically free now, but we still act like a slave. You know, we were punished for reading the Bible as slaves. When we had church, we were taught subservient messages about ourselves, you know, nothing more than that. And from the backwood slave church to today, we still refuse to read the Bible. Our slave masters were money-hungry businessmen, willing to enslave and kill an entire nation of people, and the Indians, can't forget about them. So willing to kill two entire nations to get the money they wanted and to build the industries that they wanted. And now the black man is free and loves the Most High. So what does he do? He starts a church and he enslaves his congregation to do exactly what the slave master has done. Use the congregation to get rich. You know, these ministers are doing all they've been taught to do by the founders of this country, chase after money. So now there's ministers of all races operating in the prosperity gospel movement. You cannot look at today's Christian churches and tell me that they are not businesses. When they collect your tithes and offerings, there's a budget in their minds, a quota that they have to meet. So while you're praising God with your offering, they're thinking about their bank accounts. And some of them are so bold as to count your money in front of you and tell you it's not enough and that you need to bring more. And like robots, there you go, right back to the altar to give some more of your hard-earned money. So who determines whether or not my offering is good enough? You or the Most High? And see, this should let us know that the Most High is not in this. It brings tears to my eyes because I know my people thirst after the Most High. I know they love him and they want to know more about him. Faithfully going to services 2 and 3 times a week, putting their money in the collection plates and waiting and hoping and praying for a miracle that does not come. Because they're being taught that paying their pastor equates obedience when they should have been taught that keeping the laws, as the Messiah has said and everybody else in the Bible has said, equates obedience. But like slaves, we don't read the Bible. We memorize some scriptures that make us feel good, but we don't read it. Because if you read it, you'll see what sin really is, lawlessness and failure to keep the law. If you read it, you would see what the Messiah was all about. The law. If you read it, you'll see what Paul was really talking about. We can no longer be punished for falling short of the law, but the law remains. The judgment does not, thanks to the Messiah, but the law remains. That's what it says. Read it. And I don't care if all the mega churches believe differently. I'm going to tell you like your mama would. If all the mega churches jumped off of a cliff, would you too? Because that's what they're doing. And they have you following right after them. Listen, the Messiah said in Matthew 7, straight is the gate and narrow is the way that leads to life and few find it. Remember that. It's not the masses that you follow. The Messiah says the masses aren't going to find it. Few will find the truth and follow it. So what's the first step to finding the truth? Genesis 1:1. Start over. Read the Bible again. Then read the Gospels again, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Then go over to Paul. Read Paul's words with knowledge of the foundation Paul walked on, and you'll better understand what Paul has said. But what you don't want to do is be a robot, a zombie, giving all your money to a preacher, making them rich, while you're still seeking a blessing from the Most High. There's only one way to be blessed, truly blessed, with things that money cannot buy, and that is to be obedient by keeping the commandments. You can read Deuteronomy 28 when you have time. That is the only way to be obedient. And one more thing, know your history. The Bible is the best-selling book in the world. But did you know that it's a history book? Did you know that the Israelites were a black people, as were the Messiah, as were the disciples and the Apostle Paul? They were all black people, descendants of Shem. Descendants of Japheth are your Caucasians, originating from the Caucasus areas of Russia. You know, we've become a mixed people as generations went on. But you have to know your African American history. The founders of this country will tell you that they purchased you from Africa. But what they won't tell you is that before purchasing you, you were advertised to them as the Israelite nation. They won't tell you that because knowledge is power. And they want to keep you as dumb and powerless by taking your name, your heritage, and your God. So they kill the first generations of slaves and refuse to teach the following generations the truth about who they were. We are the true descendants of the Israelite nation. And this is why I say know your history, because the Bible is only the beginning of the story. How we live our lives today is the rest of the story. We have to wake up and walk in truth. And if that means staying home from church on Sunday mornings and studying the word, then do that. See how much you learn when a preacher's not screaming in your face. You'll be amazed. The Messiah says, seek and you shall find. So this is my petition to you, to seek after the truth of the Most High. And I promise you will find it.